My name is Laurie Santos. I teach psychology at Yale University, and today I want to talk to you about anchoring. This lecture is part of a series on cognitive biases. Let's do a math problem really quickly, and you've got to do it in your head. Ready? First, multiply the following numbers: 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, that's it. What's your guess? 1,000? 2,000? When the psychologists Danny Kahneman and Amos Tversky tried this with human subjects, subjects on average guessed about 2,250. Seems like an okay guess. But now, let's suppose I gave you a different math problem. What if I gave you this one? Ready? 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times 5 times 6 times 7 times 8. What's your answer? If you're like Kahneman and Tversky's subjects, your answer might be a bit different here. For this question, their subjects guessed a lot lower. On average, they said the answer was about 512. The first amazing thing about these similar mathematical estimates is that people get the answers really, really wrong. In fact, the real answer? Well, for both, it's 40,320. People are off by an order of magnitude. But the second, even more amazing thing is that people give different answers to the two problems, even though they're just different ways of asking exactly the same question. Why do we give completely different answers when the same math problem is presented differently? The answer lies in how we make estimates. When you have lots of time to do a math problem, like 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, you can multiply all of the numbers together and get an exact product. But when you have to do the problem quickly, you don't really have time to finish. So you start with the first numbers, you multiply 8 times 7 and get 56, and then you've got to multiply that by 6, and well, you're guessing the final number's got to be pretty big, bigger than 56, like maybe 2,000 or so. But when you do the second problem, you start with 1 times 2, and well, that's only 2, and 2 times 3 is only 6. Your answer is going to be pretty small, maybe only like 500 or so. This process of guessing based on the first number you see is what's known as anchoring. The first number we think of when we do our estimate is the anchor. And once we have an anchor in our head, well, we sort of adjust as needed from there. The problem is that our minds are biased not to adjust as much as we need to. The anchors are cognitively really strong. In the first problem, you probably started with 56 and then adjusted to an even bigger number from there. And in the second problem, you started with 6 and then adjusted from there. The problem is that starting at different points leads to different final guesses. Like real anchors, our estimated anchors kind of get us stuck in one spot. We often fail to drag the anchor far enough to get to a correct answer. Kahneman and Tversky discovered that this sort of anchoring bias happens all the time, even for anchors that are totally arbitrary. For example, they asked people to spin a wheel with numbers from 1 to 100, and then asked them to estimate what percentage of countries in the United Nations are African. People who spun a 10 on the wheel estimated that the number was about 25%, but people who spun a 65 estimated that the number was 45%. In another experiment, Dan Ariely and his colleagues had people write down the last two digits of their social security number. They were then asked whether they would pay that amount in dollars for a nice bottle of wine. Ariely and colleagues found that people in the highest quintile of social security numbers would pay 3 to 4 times as much for the exact same good. Just setting up a larger anchor can make a person who would pay $8 for the bottle of wine be willing to spend $27 instead. Sadly for us, salespeople use anchors against us all the time. How many times have you noticed a salesperson or an advertisement anchoring you to a particular price, or even to how much of a particular product you should buy? Whether it's buying a car or a sweater, or even renting a hotel room, our intuitions about what prices are reasonable to pay often come from some arbitrary anchor. So the next time you're given an anchor, take a minute to think. Remember what happens when you drop your anchor too high, and then consider thinking of a very different number. It might affect your final estimate more than you expect.